we look out these windows here behind me, you'd probably see the male squirrel chasing the female squirrel. You'd probably see a male bird making a nice little nest, trying to impress the female bird. If we had a big microscope, maybe we would see a male spider doing a dance, trying to attract the female spider. It's in nature, it's all around us, and it's in our own lives. The point being, right from the beginning, we're at a disadvantage. Women are the prize. They're the prize in nature. In society, it's just the way things are. I didn't make up the rules. This is the reality we're living in. Right from the start, the woman is seen as the prize. To make it even harder, we're the ones who have to pursue. Can I get your number? Would you like to go out? You have to make a move. Now it's reinforcing the narrative even more. They were already the prize. Now you're pursuing. You're feeding into that narrative. She's the prize. She's the prize. You're chasing her. You're trying. You're working. You're investing. You need it to happen. And the monster grows. Now that's all fine and dandy, but at the end of the day, it's not giving her the number one feeling in the world. It feels great to be the prize. It feels great to have everybody chasing you. And sometimes, and in some points of your life, you probably really like that. But what women really want is to have that number one feeling, getting to play the game a little themselves, get to chase, work, invest, try, feel like they're getting the prize. So how do you do this, right? I call this the big reversal, right? We have to reverse everything we see, everything in nature and society, to give her the feeling that she's getting the prize, that she's getting something better. Again, not for your benefit, not to make you cool, for her benefit, for her pleasure. Give her the pleasure of feeling like she's getting the prize, even if you were just kind of creating this world out of thin air and using humor to do it, right? You have the belief, I'm the prize, conveying that with humor for her pleasure, for her benefit. When you first do this, she might say, yeah, right, you wish, whatever, roll her eyes, but over time she'll appreciate that you are creating the world, but she's chasing you and you are the prize. Now today we're not going to talk about how to do that through text messaging. I actually have a new program out. I will leave a link below. 100 of the most attractive text messages that make women chase. So that's all in one place, a great reference for you if you want to check that out. Today I want to talk about allowing a woman to invest in you, to treat you, to put in energy, to put in time to get you. Allow her to do it. Now the first example is, I went on a date with a girl and she had asked me out. So now, really technically the rule is when somebody asks you out, they should pay, right? Usually if you're asking a woman out, you pay, right? If she wants to chip in, you can allow that, right? So if she says, you know, if you asked her out, you're not going to say, all right, let's split the bill for dinner. No, you don't do that. You asked her out, you're going to pay. But if she offers, you can say, no, I asked you out, I got it. But hey, if you want to get the ice cream after, we're going, or if you want to, you know, get the parking, allow her to do that if she wants to chip in. Because if she's chipping in and helping out, it only feels more and more like she's invested in you. But anyway, back to my story. So this girl had asked me out and we were playing, like a place like Top Golf, right? And she said, here's $50. I want you to pay with this $50 because I don't want my friends to see that I'm paying for you, right? Because two of her friends were there. Now, normally what a nice guy, you know, quote unquote, the nice wimpy guy would do in that situation, he would say, no, I got it, I get it. I don't want you to feel weird. Your friends are here and you're buying the guy this. But I said, oh, okay, cool. And I took the money and I allowed her to pay. Is it because I'm broke? No. Is it because I'm like, yeah, I get women to pay for me, man? Yeah. No. I know I want to allow her the pleasure of chipping in, of feeling like she's chasing, of investing in this interaction. They get pleasure about it. It's not about the money. It's not about the $50, right? Of course, in the future, I'd ask that girl out and I would pay. No problem, of course. But I'm not going to miss an opportunity to allow her to chip in, invest, and help out. Again, not for me. Yeah, man, got a free golf round in. No one cares. But what I did get in is a woman feeling like, man, I'm putting effort into this in a world where all of the time they're the prize, they're actually getting to chip in, which is good. Now, what comes up a lot too is sometimes a woman will say, you know, hey, you know, I'm out. I can actually, you know, if you want, I can get us breakfast. I can swing by. I can drop you off some breakfast. A lot of guys, nah, don't worry about it. Don't hassle yourself. Don't do that. I'm fine. They have donuts here in the teacher's lounge. No, you want to take advantage of that, right? You want to say, yeah, that'd be awesome. Bring me breakfast. But you could also take it a step further with humor to, again, reinforce this idea that you're the prize. So you say, hey, yeah, I really like, oh, that's awesome. I really like poppy seed bagels, but I like it lightly toasted. I like light butter. And this is important. This is really important. Make sure there's not too many poppy seeds. Again, this is done with playful humor, right? It's playful humor, but she'll actually go through the thing. She'll get you the bagel and say, look, it's good. It's lightly toasted and it doesn't have that many poppy seeds. Especially if she likes you, right? She wants to impress you. She wants to put in the effort. She wants to put in the work. And it's all lighthearted and fun. Again, this isn't something where you high-five and your buddies, yeah, man, I got her to get me a bagel with only 42 poppy seeds. We're winning. It's not about that. You're allowing her to feel that feminine joy of I'm investing, I'm chasing, I'm working for this guy. So you made it funny. Or you could say, yeah, I love muffins, but this is real serious. I love a good stump to top ratio. Really try to pick me out the best one. I'm counting on you. And again, it's ha ha ha, but they actually kind of go through the thing of getting you that muffin. They're like, look at this muffin I got. Is it good? You go, yeah, it's pretty good. This is a good muffin. Good job. You want to allow her to be able to do stuff like that. If she says things like, do you need anything when she's out? You say, yeah, matter of fact, I could use that. Now, another thing that comes up is birthdays, right? If you can get lucky enough to have a birthday, your birthday come up when you've had only like 3 or 4 dates with her, man, that is really awesome, because if she's starting to like you, she's going to want to make a big deal about your birthday. She's going to probably ask you out. And again, the nice guy is going to go, no, it's okay. I'll take you out. It's okay. Don't make a big deal about my birthday. No, allow her to make a big deal about it, because what it shows is she's into you. She's going to invest. She's going to get you a gift. She's going to take you to a special place. Allow it all to happen. She says, oh, I'm going to take you to this really awesome restaurant. You go, okay, we'll see. I hope it's good. It is my birthday. After all, I'm expecting big things. And she's going to go all out. Again, please, before people at home go wild, he's getting her to do stuff. What the hell? For her pleasure, for her benefit, it's done with humor. It's done half serious. Is he serious? He likes his bagel with 122 poppy seeds? He likes his muffin tops and stumps at a good ratio. Jokes. Now come up with your own. You don't have to use mine. But allow her to try. Allow her to invest. Allow her to put in this effort that furthers the narrative that you're the prize. It's very hard to reverse the narrative of the universe that the female is the prize. You're really working against it here. So you got to use your humor, and you've got to, when you get the chance, allow them to want to do stuff for you. This helps the feeling, wow, he's the prize. I'm going for it for her benefit. So she wakes up in the morning feeling great. You're still the gentleman. You're still the classy guy. You still do great stuff for her, but you allow her to also do stuff for you. Guys, appreciate you so much watching the video. Remember, if you are not the prize, all of the other problems in your relationships are secondary. You need to be the prize for her benefit. We're going to have a lot of videos talking about this topic. So if you're not subscribed, I would do that right now, or you're not going to see them. You're going to miss it. And it was going to be the one video that explained it all to you where the light bulb went off. So make sure you're subscribed to the channel. Appreciate you guys watching. Hit a like if you enjoyed this. Leave a comment if you have any ideas about being the prize. And I'll see you in the next one.